Como é que é, pessoal? Bem-vindos novamente ao Underground's Voice ao vivo. Os meus convidados de hoje são os lendários Overkill. Thank you so much for being here. It's a huge, huge honor to meet you. You're a living legend of thrash metal, so you're playing since 1998. I was born 10 years later, so...
1985.
85.
Yeah.
Okay, I was born...
Thank you. Obrigado.
Really, you're a thrash metal legend. I'm a thrash metal guy, so for me it's awesome to be here with you. It's a huge honor. Welcome to Portugal. Welcome to Oporto. What can you expect about tonight's show?
Oh, great country. I mean, I've come here for vacations, so I know a little bit here, a little bit there. I mean, we've done Vagos Festival. We've played Lisboa a few times. This is our second time in Porto. I've spent time here with my wife. I like the country.
Cool.
I like the scene. It's a very passionate audience.
Yeah.
I think that this is probably one of the European countries that we have not had multiple gigs in. You know, maybe in my entire life, there's 10.
Probably.
So it's kind of special for us, I think, and hopefully for those who come. So
it is.
So what I expect is an Overkill show, which is always over the top, but a little bit more enthusiasm because only 10 shows in 30 years.
Yeah. As I said before, you're a living legend. How do you feel when you think about that at home? You know, Overkill is a huge band. You're famous everywhere. You released a lot of albums. You're a big influence to the new bands, for a lot of bands. How do you feel when you think about that?
Well, it makes me a little red-faced when you use the word legend too many times. Yeah. I still think of myself as a worthwhile contributor to the scene. And, you know, when you see a living legend cutting his own lawn and working on his own car, he's no longer a legend.
That's true.
So, I like to think of myself always as a regular guy who's been a supporter of the scene. And it's given me, you know, a great opportunity to meet people like you and Diana. And I think that that's kind of the cool thing.
Yeah.
To be afforded the opportunity to travel for 30 years and meet people into the same shit I'm into.
Yeah.
I mean, how cool is that?
Yeah.
So, you know, shouldn't be an old man's game, but for some reason it's turned into one. Which I have no problem with because I still enjoy doing it. And we'll do it as long as I can do it physically. So.
Yeah. Would you believe if someone say that back in the days when Overkill started, that Overkill would be so big band? Would you believe that?
Well, I don't know we're such a big band even at this point. I think that we are what we are and we accept it. I mean, we're a middle-level thrash band. I mean, we know what we are. I think knowing what you are and accepting it gives you the opportunity to be honest, truthful with your presentation. This is not something that's necessarily done for money, but done for the love of it first. Yeah. And to be able to do that for this many years and still have it, let's say, affordable to do.
Yeah.
It's a great opportunity to live your life. So I would never say that what I know in 1985 that Overkill would be a big band. I would just hope in 1985 that we would be able to continue as long as we could. So.
Well, a couple of months ago, Mike Portnoy posted a photo with you with Phil Demo. What can you expect about that? Can we expect some big news?
Well, they all owe me money. That's why. Oh. No, it's just it's big news, but it was a fun project. It was kind of, you would say it was a summertime hobby project, and what we did was, so Phil, Mike, Mark Menge from Metal Allegiance, and myself did a record called Made in America, the 1970s, so we took American bands that were done in the 70s, only in 1970s, and thrashed up the approach. Grand Funk's American band, a band called Mountain from Long Island, New York, a band called Cactus from Long Island, New York, Blue Oyster Cult. You know, this type of approach. But we put the Machine Head, Sons of Apollo, Metal Allegiance, Overkill,
cool
spin on the whole thing. So it's actually a cool project, and we're mixing it. Yeah, we'll be mixing it this week.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Well, The Wings of War was released in February, a couple of months ago. It's a great, great album. Probably one of the best Overkill albums, in my opinion. How do you guys can still to be fresh after so many years and after release so many albums? And also you can do some new experience like Distortion, for example.
Well, it's a great compliment to say that. I mean, this many years later, that first of all, we take it seriously. We don't mail in our or sit in our rooms and say, oh, here are my tracks, make something nice. I mean, we sweat it out and playing and singing and drumming through rehearsals. We're involved in each other's tracks. We still hold it at a high regard. But I think it's about opportunity. If opportunity comes to you, not to say, oh, it's another opportunity, then it's not an opportunity, then it's a pain in the ass. I think we say, another opportunity? Let's make this happen. I don't think we try to force any differences like Distortion, but for sure we have, I think one of the successes that we have as Overkill is that we all like different music. I mean, Dave Linsk is Mr. Heavy. He's blast beat. Dave Linsk, he loves that shit. Dee Dee Verney will listen to anything from Broadway songs to punk rock. Myself, I love classic rock and roll, everything from the Rolling Stones to The Who, and Derek Taylor likes a little bit of the new stuff. Jason Bittner's Benny Chadha's Fall. I think what happens is that we don't force a chemistry, but we let each other breathe through our songs. So I think The Wings of War is something that's special, especially this many years after our start, to still sound fresh.
Well, the album is being with a great feedback from the fans, from the reviews. Do you think that maybe in 20 years, can it be a classic like, for example, Taking Over or Horoscope?
I don't know. I mean, that's only
possible,
a guess.
Right?
I would love it. I would love it if it was. But I think after this many records, I think I'm a realist and say, hey, man, for the moment, this reflects the scene.
Yeah.
This reflects us, at this time. I think it's, again, a key to Overkill success is don't overthink what you have. Just know who you are and do the best you can under the circumstances.
Yeah.
And if that's the principle or the philosophy, we're probably going to get pretty good results.
Yeah. Well, I saw one review. Someone said that Overkill is one of the most consistent thrash metal bands ever, saying that, for example, bands like Slayer or Creator had some bad moments in their careers, but Overkill have always stayed in the right track. What do you have to say about that?
Well, I think we've had our bad moments, and I'm a firm believer in the fact that mistakes are necessary, because mistakes only show you how you can do better.
Yeah.
Would you forget the mistake? Of course not, because this way I don't repeat the mistake.
Yeah.
So I think that's necessary. I think for us, I think that why it works is not about mistakes, but it's more about understanding that we're best when we work on a clock. We're not artists, we're more workmen about it. So that's why, as the clock goes every 2 years, a new record comes. As the clock goes every 2 years, the record comes.
Yeah.
So we know we're writing, we're recording, we're promoting, we're touring, we're writing, we're good. So that works for us, that routine. So that's not an artist. I think an artist is someone who sits on a desert island with supermodels and complains that nobody understands his genius. I think in our case, we complain, there's not enough time in the day to do another song.
That's true. Well, you are really accessible persons. It's easy to see you hanging out with the fans after the show or before the show.
Sure.
Do you think that's important to, or maybe it's the best way to show to the fans and everyone that you feel grateful for what you have, for what you do?
That's a great question. I think it's two reasons. I think for sure I'm grateful. I mean, being in Porto tonight, these people have given me the opportunity to do this for this long. For me to be ungrateful would only make me an asshole. But for me to, for someone to say, "Can I have 2 minutes of your time?" Of course you can.
Yeah.
You know, that's simple. That's human.
That's so, really great.
You know, and that's human. You know, I also think the only way to be an overkill is to be a fan first of the music.
Yeah.
Not to think of yourself as the artist, but to think of yourself as the fan. And what would you do if, as a fan, if you had that moment? I would make the most of it.
Yeah.
So I think that that's why our philosophy works for us. It's been said, you know, for years, it's one of the American bands that you can sit on the top of the car and open a cold six pack with two of the guys in Overkill and listen to the new Slayer.
Yeah.
Yeah. because we like it, you know. So for me, it works. You know, for me, it works. I don't like to think of myself as anything but the guy who rides and fixes his own motorcycle and cuts his own grass.
Well, Overkill grew up with bands, with legends, right? With the Creator, with Slayer, with the Metallica, with Sodom, with a lot of bands. So how do you see the farewell of Slayer right now?
Well, I like, you know, I mean, I really like Tom. I've always, you know, Tom's always been a genuine person. I think, I don't think I ever laugh so much when Tom Array and I get in one room. We say hello, we laugh, you know.
Yeah.
So it's always a really good feeling. And I remember stories all the way back to the beginning when they were really the first band to take us out on the road for the U.S. tour. And then we were together with them through 1988 with Slayer, Motorhead, Overkill, you know, and then Slayer, Overkill through Europe.
Yeah.
I mean, what a fucking great couple of years. So, I mean, we got to know these guys and they were genuine people. I think they should do what they want. I respect the fact that they've probably done three times the amount of shows we've done in that time, because they're workhorses.
Yeah.
So a huge amount of respect. The fact that we were there at the beginning with them, I thought was also something special, and I hope that they get what they want. I think they've achieved something really, really unique with the fact that they're the most extreme thrash band that ever existed.
Yeah.
On the face of the earth, and good people.
They're great guys.
Yeah.
It's kind of sad too, because we also have new great thrash metal bands, but bands like Slayer or that's one of them. Yeah, they're great. Bands like Slayer are completely immortal. It's kind of the Michael Jackson of the thrash metal, or the Queen of thrash metal.
But no white glove.
No, without the glove. It's sad because we have a lot of great thrash metal bands, or a new wave of thrash metal, but we can't say one band that we look at them and we say they will be number one. When Slayer, when Metallica, when Overkill, when they quit, we don't have one single band that you say they'll be the one.
I agree.
Yeah.
Nobody stands out to take the flag.
Yeah.
Yeah, which should happen.
Probably.
I think probably the biggest issue with regard to that is, for instance, these guys were, we've had them on the road a few times.
Yeah.
And, I mean, great guys. I love Nick.
Yeah.
But the template is that of the 80s. So if you take the template and you apply it to the present day, you need to break out of the template to show where your originality is. And I think Suicidal Angels, for instance, has broken out of that. But is it a time to break out and be able to capture the hearts and the minds of the thrash fans through Europe, America, Asia, South America? So I don't know that. Now, I haven't seen somebody who's been able to do it.
Yeah. Well, finally, thank you so much for being here once again. Huge honor to meet you. It means a lot to me to be here meeting you.
My pleasure.
Last words for the Portuguese fans and Underground Voice viewers.
Obrigado.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Once
right,
again.
Man. Chris,
Overkill and Underground Voice. Fiquem atentos. Nós voltamos em breve.